We will not fear. Gone back and forth, and if this is the best title for this. It's a good title, but it needs to be shouted, not just read. See, it doesn't read very well. And you need to have a huge emphasis, like make them all caps, on will not in the middle. We will not fear. Now, most of you in here know that fear is not supposed to be a part of the Christian life. Some of you, that might be new information. If you hang around Ellerslie for any length of time, I'm going to play that message one way or the other every 6 months or so. You're going to have a clear understanding that fear is not a part of the Christian life. So many of us in here have at least accepted that, and we've seen some massive breakthroughs. Some of us that were addicted to anxiety would always turn to it, fear, foreboding, fretting. We've seen massive change in our lives in that area. However, there can oftentimes still be a residue of low-lying fear that just sort of sits there in our life. And we accept it because, well, look, I mean, I've taken such great steps forward. You can't expect 100% freedom from something, can you? We do this in a lot of areas in our life too. In other words, because you know how gross it was in your past, you have a tendency to accept the less gross state that you may be in now. And I just want to, as a fresh lecture to each of our souls, say that there is no allowance for darkness at any level. There is no residue that is allowed to be there. There are certain things that the fungus of the kingdom of darkness can grow on. And that is disobedience to the king. And when we do not stand in perfect alignment with the word of God expressed, then fungus, or in our case, fear, can grow. Fear is merely the result of the lack of God's truth permeating our life, because truth makes free. God does not give the spirit of fear. He is not the one that is giving foreboding and fretting and anxiety. That is a result of a departure from a clear alliance with the word of God. God speaks, we say, it's true. And then all fear is cast out. When you live in light of truth, fear has no breeding ground, none. So as we go through this, it's just a very fascinating exercise for the soul to behold how we oftentimes will diminish God's word, not intentionally, but we will just subtly push it down. There's something about fear that makes us feel like we're doing something. It makes us feel active in the situation. Whereas strict believing in the word of God doesn't always seem to be the most sufficient answer. I need to do something. I need to fret. I need to be anxious about this. Instead of just resting and saying, God said it. Isn't that enough for all of us? He promised. We will not fear. I'll show you where I got that from. Psalm 46:2. We will not fear. Now, I'm going to give you the full context for that as we move forward. But what a statement. We will not fear. Speaking of the Jewish nation, the Hebrew nation that has been given the promises of Almighty God. We will not fear. Whoa, could you imagine an army marching into battle with that? We will not fear.